Well, if decluttering feels hard, it might just be because you're doing it backwards.
So, because you're doing it wrong, no problem.
Total, it's a really easy fix. We will tell you exactly how today.
I love that Dawn just told you you're doing it all wrong.
No, it's just, but it's like literally just a like,
whoop, a mindset.
Just switch it back around and you'll be on your way.
Okay. Yep.
Well, hi, I'm Dawn from The Minimal Mom. Our whole goal is to make simplifying your house quick and easy. And so that's what we're all about. Always glad to have my twin sister, Diana, with us as well. And so I had this idea because I know what it's like. We're like, okay, I'm gonna declutter the closet, right? And we like hype ourselves up and we're like, I'm gonna get rid of so much of it. And we get like two decisions in and we're like, what am I doing? Do I need this? I might need this. I don't wanna waste money. I'm not just gonna donate it and then I have to go buy it again. And we get kind of flustered and we're like, I can't do this. What was I thinking? And this is why my house is how it is, right? Like, has that ever happened?
Yeah, my anxiety level just raised like 10 points.
Okay, so. Okay, so let's do this. Let's say you're packing for a trip for Hawaii. You're gonna go spend a week in the sunshine. It is freezing cold in Minnesota right now.
Oh, the anxiety just dropped
okay,
right back
I'm trying
down.
To take you Good, back down
thank
again.
You, yeah.
So, isn't this so cool? A week long in Hawaii. We're gonna try and fit everything in our carry-on luggage because who wants to pay extra? But let's face it, we're going to Hawaii. Like, we just need shorts and tank tops and a swimsuit, right? Yeah. So we have our carry-on luggage here. So we're packing for Hawaii. We have our boundary here, right? Like, everything has to fit in our carry-on, right?
And under like 30 pounds or something.
Yeah, right. And so we gotta be realistic about what we're bringing with to Hawaii. And so let's say we pull out our suitcase and we're like, oh, well, this is silly. My parka was in there from when I went to Alaska. Now, would I say, you know what? I should probably take this with to Hawaii just in case, right? Like, just, I mean, you never know. I know that, like, it never goes below 50 in Hawaii, but, or 60, I don't know. Hawaii's so
70, it's amazing.
I don't know.
Yeah.
But let's just put it back in there just in case, right? Okay. I mean, I don't have as much room for my other stuff. It's kind of over, it's over 30 pounds now. It's over full. Or how about this one? This, I think, would be funny. We have it full of our Hawaii stuff, but I'm gonna just like tie this on. Like, I'm just gonna tie, I'm gonna attach it to the outside. And I'm just gonna like drag it with me.
Because I don't actually have room for it.
It doesn't fit in there. But you know what? Just in case, I'm gonna let this thing overflow and I'm just gonna drag it along with me. Like, we wouldn't do that.
Well, and how stressful would that be?
Right, now our stress is going back up again. Like, people are
they gonna
catch me at the gate, you know?
You're that person on the plane.
And so where I think we get backwards is that we take these items in our house and the only question we ask ourselves is, would I possibly use it in the future? Instead of stopping ourselves and saying, where am I going? What season am I in? And where am I headed this next year to 5 years? Am I parenting little kids? Am I parenting teens? Am I wanting to do something bigger and better with my life? That I don't need this stuff that I used in the past because it doesn't need to go with me into this next season and it's not gonna support me in this next season.
That, I think right there, to ask the right question instead of the wrong question. So again, the wrong question is, could I possibly use this in the future? Mm-hmm. Because pretty much everything in your home does have potential,
right?
You know, but to get really real about where am I going? I'm going to Hawaii.
Right.
I mean, when you look through that lens, then a parka is ridiculous, you know? And what I love about this is the more you do it, and the more time that passes, the more sure of yourself that you become. Now, just a couple years in, I'm like, out of here.
Right.
Like, nope. I ask myself those things without even thinking, and I have so much confidence as I'm getting things out of our house.
And I think practically what this has looked like in my life is there is a lot of like half-finished sewing projects and craft projects, and I'm trying to think books that I thought I was gonna read that I was continually never getting around to. I know for our homeschooling friends, there are curriculums that you have been hanging on to thinking maybe one of your kids, but they're already past the age.
Yep.
And so we know how this goes, these things that we wanna hang on to, but if we lighten our load, we don't have to worry about being overweight or, you know, getting caught up at the gate where they charge you to like gate check it or whatever. Your home is gonna not only feel like a more enjoyable place to be, but I feel like you are gonna feel empowered in this next season. Yeah. You are gonna feel like,
I've got just the things I need. I'm traveling light, I'm flexible, I can move, I can change, I can go where I need to go, and I'm not being weighed down by all this stuff that I don't need.
And one thing that I've learned too is as I'm actually donating something or putting it in the trash, sometimes there can be regret tied to that. Like, oh, I spent money on that or whatever.
Totally.
But I've been telling myself, okay, lesson learned. Like, I'm not gonna bring this into my home again. Oh, I overbought here. I got too many clothes for this season for my baby. I mean, sometimes you just have to take it a little bit easy on yourself and be like, wow, I've never had a 1-year-old before.
Right.
I thought the 1T or the 12-month clothing would fit her.
Right.
Well, I didn't know she'd be in 2T right now.
Yeah.
You know, and so like, don't be too hard on yourself.
Right.
You know, and so, but no, once that item is out of your home, you are not gonna think of it again. And you're gonna be enjoying the beach. You're gonna be enjoying a simplified life where your mind is more clear. Think on vacation, your mind is clear.
Yeah.
The day kind of unfolds before you and you're like, what are we gonna do today?
Mm-hmm.
And that is possible in our day-to-day life.
Yeah.
Well, and I think you find too, so I'm going to put my pastor hat on if that's okay. As we simplify our life, that's when we have space for the lifestyle changes that we want to make. We're still kind of toward the beginning of the year, and maybe at that point where weight loss goals have, you know, maybe we've found some traction, or maybe they've gone out the window, and or maybe Bible reading or whatever that lifestyle changes that you want to make. That's the other thing about simple living, is I just found it's given me the capacity to do those things that are more important to me or even eternal.
Yeah.
And so we've been encouraging you to download the She Reads Truth Bible Reading Plan app. I just love, I mean, for me in this stage of life, baby number two's on the way, having it on my phone is essential.
Yeah.
I still love a paper Bible and paper journal.
Yeah.
But like, I can only imagine what Adley, my 1-year-old, would do to that right now. So it just needs to be safely on my phone. And so the app is great. You can even set up reminders every morning to be reading your Bible. The passages aren't too long, and then it has some explanation or commentary afterwards. And so we've been tracking through a reading plan called The Life of Moses.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to look that up. And I was like, you know what, in the new year, let's just dig into the Old Testament. Let's find the hardest passages that we can.
Yep.
And let's just go for it. And if you have been tracking along, you would have gone through the beginning of Exodus. And if you remember this part, maybe even from Sunday school growing up, but basically Moses is trying to deliver the Israelites from Egypt. And so he like brings all of these plagues on the people.
Mm-hmm.
And he's trying to convince Pharaoh to let his people go. And you know, there's so many things about the Bible that can be confusing. And again, that's what I love about this app, is it helps bring a lot of explanation.
Right.
And it even was sharing in there that these plagues, so like the first one is that they actually turned the water to blood. I mean, just gross, right? And confusing, and like, how is this a good thing? And there ended up being plague after plague. And what happened is Pharaoh's heart was getting harder and harder. But the people, they actually were looking at this and they were like, who is this God? Like, look at the power. And what I never knew before is that every plague was actually designed to kind of take head on one of the Egyptian gods.
Oh.
And so the Nile, so the very first one, this turning the water in the Nile River to blood, was actually their greatest god. They would go down to the water, they would worship it, because Egypt was, I mean, it was a place of life, of prosperity, because of the Nile River.
Okay.
Because of what it meant for commerce, what it meant for the health of the people to have clean drinking water for their herds and their animals. And so, I mean, this was the thing that was worshipped above all else. And then here they are. So, this is just disgusting. But imagine what once was this beautiful, pristine, flowing river is now flowing with blood and the smell.
Yeah.
And what that meant for your family, and now you're thirsty. And, you know, just how difficult that would be.
Right.
But what's so beautiful about this is what happened to the hearts of the people is they actually turned toward the Israelites and their God, mm-hmm. such that when the Israelites were delivered, they plundered the Egyptians. And how did that happen? Other than the Egyptians were giving them their gold and their belongings, because they're like, surely this God is the most real.
Mm-hmm.
And to bring that home to our lives, sometimes we can feel like sickness or loss or disaster comes upon us, and maybe like the Lord's trying to teach us a lesson, you know, or we're hoping it'll come upon others so that the Lord will teach them a lesson. But really here we see it's actually the Lord compelling the people unto him.
Mm-hmm.
He's not trying to bring pain and destruction in their life. He's trying to demonstrate to them his almighty power and goodness. And in Romans it even says it's the
goodness of the Lord that leads us to repentance. Yeah. So if we have people that we feel like need to repent in our lives, or if it's us, it's actually demonstrating to them the goodness of God, His compassion, His love, His mercy, and not sitting there judging them or wagging our finger at them. It's loving them and just having a right picture of our God, and that that's who He is. And He's constantly, He sent Jesus to constantly be loving the world back to Him.
That's really good.
So I'll just pray for us now. So Father, we just thank You for Your goodness. And Lord, I just ask right now if You would just touch any mindsets, Lord, that don't line up with You being good and merciful and loving and just. Would You help us to see You in Your truest form, Lord, and the love that You have for the world and for each one of us, and the patience and the mercy and the kindness that You express toward us, to love us into relationship with You. So Father, we bless those in our lives today who need to know Your goodness and Your mercy. And Lord, even for each one of us today, that we would just receive Your forgiveness and Your salvation and the hope that we have in eternity with You afresh. So I bless each one of us now in Jesus' name, amen.